Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss regarding urinary tract infections. So we all know the urinary tract on the different parts of urinary tract, so which majorly includes kidneys, ureters, bladder, urethra and urethral opening, that means urethral orifice. So kidneys and ureters, these are considered as upper urinary tract, and bladder and urethra, these two are considered as lower urinary tract. And so an infection to this urinary tract, so that means either to the kidney or ureters, bladder or urethra, whatever is considered as urinary tract infection. So most commonly we will observe infections in lower urinary tract, so that means bladder and urethra. Women will be at a greater risk of developing urinary tract infections when compared to the men. And mostly the infection will be limited to bladder and can be painful and annoying. So in some serious conditions, so that urinary tract infection will spread to your kidneys also. So the upper urinary tract infection, so kidney, that means if it has a infection to the kidneys, you will call it as pyelonephritis, and if it is for ureters, we will call it as ureteritis. And coming to the lower urinary tract infections, which is we will call it as cystitis if it affects the bladder, and if it affects the urethra, we will call it as urethritis. So cystitis is the most common form of lower urinary tract infection, and urethritis is observed most oftenly, it's a sexually transmitted one. And coming to this urinary tract infections, so coming to the pyelonephritis, so we have three different forms of pyelonephritis: acute pyelonephritis, chronic pyelonephritis and tuberculous pyelonephritis. Coming to the causes, that means we all know, so urinary tract infection is caused by bacteria, so it means it's nothing but a microorganism, since it is an infection. So what are all the different conditions which allows the entry of that microorganism are into the urinary bladder include stasis of urine. Whenever if you hold the urine for a longer period, so by not avoiding that, at the time the individual will have a increased risk of damage to the bladder. So that means the bladder muscles contraction will get damaged, which increases the increased entry of that microorganism into your urinary system, as well as sexual activity, pregnancy, urinary catheterization and presence of stones. All this will increases the risk of infection, and the pregnant woman will be at a greater risk of developing urinary tract infections, as well as the diabetic women also. And compared to the other individuals, these two women, pregnant women as well as diabetic women, will be at a greater risk. And sometimes this urinary tract infection may lead to prematurity and perinatal death also. So it is mandatory to screen all the pregnant women to that means to screen so it is mandatory to screen all the pregnant women for urinary tract infection. Coming to this acute pyelonephritis, so it is nothing but acute suppurative inflammation of the kidney by a pyogenic bacteria. So we already said pyelonephritis is an upper urinary tract infection, and the most common causes include E. coli, Enterobacter, Klebsiella, Pseudomonas and Proteus. And whatever the pyelonephritis, acute pyelonephritis, which is there, so it will occur in two ways. One is by ascending infection, and the second one is by hematogenous infection, which is also known as descending infection. So if you see the ascending infection, it is the most common route of infection, where the microorganism which is there, which will enter from the urethral orifice, that means which is there in the fecal matter. So whenever the individual will not maintain a proper vaginal hygiene or fecal hygiene, so that microorganism will enter into enter from anus to the urethral orifice, and from that urethral orifice slowly the bacteria will move upwards by adhering to the urethral, that means urethra, so by adhering to the urethral walls, and slowly it will move to the urinary bladder. Sometimes it will also occur during sexual activity. And whatever the microorganism which was entered into the urethra, slowly it will move towards the bladder, and then to your ureters, and then to your kidneys, causing urinary tract infection. And ascending infection is more susceptible in the diabetic individuals, pregnant women, as well as those who are getting suffered from any urinary tract obstructions. So on the bacteria will get multiply in urinary tract and produces asymptomatic bacteriuria. So in the initial stages of this urinary tract infection, we won't observe any symptoms, but whatever the bacteria which was already entered, so in the bladder or in the urinary tract, so it will get multiplied. And after urethritis, the bacteria ascends upwards the ureters, so further upwards the ureters and extend into renal pelvis and then into the renal cortex, causing a very severe urinary tract infection. Coming to the hematogenous route of infection, it is a very simple one. So it's nothing but a descending infection. So infection which is there in the blood. So if the individual is getting suffered from any systemic infection, then that bacteria, that means bacteria containing blood, will come to your kidneys to get filtered. There the bacteria will cause damage to the kidneys, and from kidneys the infection will move forward, so that means move forward to the ureters as well as bladder and then urethra. This happen more in individuals with obstructive lesions in urinary tract and as well as the immunosuppressed individuals. So here we can see the entry of that bacteria which is causing that urinary tract infection from urethra to urinary bladder, and there it will get multiplied and move towards ureters and then into kidneys. And the clinical features of this acute pyelonephritis include chills and fever, low in pain, lumbar tenderness will be there. Along with that, we will observe disturbances in urination and increased frequency of urination. And so if you observe urine, we will observe so many number of bacteria under microscope, and we will also observe pus cells as well as pus cell gas in urinary sediments. Coming to the chronic pyelonephritis, so this chronic pyelonephritis is a chronic tubulointerstitial disease resulting from repeated attacks of acute inflammation, inflammation and scarring. That means acute pyelonephritis, if an individual is getting suffered from repeated attacks of acute pyelonephritis, it results in chronic pyelonephritis. Depending upon the etiology and pathogenesis, there we have two different forms of chronic pyelonephritis. One is reflex nephropathy and the second one is obstructive pyelonephritis. So in reflex nephropathy, we will observe reflux of urine from the bladder into one or both of the ureters during micturition, and it is the major cause of pyelonephritis. Generally, whatever the urine which was formed in the kidneys, so it will travel from ureters to the bladder and there it will get stored. And whenever you have a good volume of urine, so that micturition will happen, so that urine through urethra and as well as urethral orifice, it will be voided. But so in case of reflux nephropathy, reflux of urine will happen from bladder into the ureters, so backwards, so during micturation. It's the major cause of this reflux nephropathy. So this vesicoureteric reflux most commonly observed in case of children and especially in girls. Reflux causes increased pressure on the renal pelvis, so that the urine is forced to renal tubules. So vesicoureteric reflux is more common in patients with urinary tract infection. So that means if the individual is already getting suffered from urinary tract infections, acute pyelonephritis or some other things, so then the individuals will be at a greater risk of this vesicoureteric reflux. Coming to the obstructive pyelonephritis, so obstruction to the outflow of urine at different levels predisposes the kidney to infection. So that may be because of prostate hyperplasia, or that may be because of presence of renal stones or whatever may be. So recurrent episodes of such obstruction and infection results in renal damage and scarring. Rarely recurrent attacks of acute pyelonephritis may cause this damage. Patients with clinical features of chronic renal failure as well as hypertension, so that means we will observe the symptoms of chronic renal failure as well as hypertension in this obstructive pyelonephritis patients, and along with that we will also observe the symptoms which are similar to that of acute pyelonephritis. Coming to tuberculous pyelonephritis, so this tuberculous pyelonephritis is not different from the normal acute pyelonephritis, where the microorganisms will changes from a normal bacteria to a Mycobacterium tuberculosis. And so this Mycobacterium tuberculosis may enter into your kidneys and causes infection, either from the systemic in, so it means either it may be from the so genitourinary system. So if the individual is getting suffered from any tuberculous infection which is affected to the genitourinary system, from the genitourinary system the infection will affect the kidneys, resulting in resulting in the development of tuberculosis pyelonephritis. Sometimes, if there is any tuberculosis or in tuberculosis infection, epididymis or fallopian tubes, that may also spread to your kidneys, resulting in tuberculosis pyelonephritis. Thank you.